Good afternoon, everybody. You are about to watch Deeper Life Bible Church program, the Moment of Transformation. Today, by the grace of the Lord, we shall listen to our pastor, General Superintendent, Pastor W.F. Kumuyi. You are going to be blessed. It is my wish that you call your family to come and listen to you as our pastor is blessing you with his holiness message. Be blessed.
I want to bring one word before you today. As we go through this year, yes, it's what I'm giving to you today, but it's not only for today, it's for every day of this year. In fact, it's for the rest of our lives. Is that word better? The word better. I want you to look at the word of God. I'm showing you some scriptures now, and you're going to see that word over and over and over again in the Old Testament, in the New Testament, the word better. We're looking at Ezekiel chapter 36, and I'm looking at verse 11, and here the Lord wants you to hold on to this word. If things have been upside down, not all right, it's this way and that way, and you're not sure of what is happening or what is going to happen, I'm telling you that things are going to turn around for the better in your life, in your family, and in the church, in Jesus' name. It is not a year to hang your head and be so sorrowful and say, I don't know what is happening, I don't know what will happen. Take all those sorrows away and all the suffering away and dry up all those tears, because better things are waiting every one of us this year. Ezekiel chapter 36, I'm reading from verse 11. And I will multiply upon you man and beast, and they shall increase and bring forth fruit, and I will settle you after your old estates. And I will do better unto you than at your beginnings. And ye shall know that I am the Lord. How wonderful our God is, that is thinking about you. He was there before you got there, because all his works are known unto him from the beginning of the world. Before this year came, he was there already. He knew that the year was coming. He knew you will be there. He knew you will be here today, sitting to hear the word of God. And he already prepared some better things for you. That's why he said in that place, I will settle you after your old estates. And then he says, I will do better unto you than at your beginnings. And ye shall know that I am the Lord, says the Lord. Look at Isaiah. And we're looking at the word better, better, because that is what the Lord wants to do for you this year. In Isaiah chapter 56, verse 5. Isaiah chapter 56, and in verse 5, it says, even unto them will I give in mine house and within my walls a place and a name better than of sons and of daughters. A name and a place better. When you think about that, a better position, a better possession, a better place, and a better possession that you're going to have spiritually, materially, and in every way. He says, I'll give them a place, I'll give them a name better than the son, than of sons and of daughters. And I will give them an everlasting name that shall not be cut off. That means that the better things he wants to do at this time is not something for us to just get and forget. It's something that is going to continue. We're looking at Matthew chapter 6, verses 26 and 33. Matthew chapter 6. And we're looking at verse 26. It tells us that these are the words of the Lord Jesus Christ himself. What he said he will do, what he said he will give. And he's telling you that this year is not the year of a decline, a year of decrease, a year of going down, a year of worse things and bad things happening. It's a year of better, better things. Whatever you had in the past, however good it might have been, better things are coming this year for you and for me and for every one of us in Jesus' name. Matthew chapter 6, we're looking at verse 26. Behold, the fowls of the air, for they sow not, neither do they reap, nor gather into barns, yet your heavenly Father feedeth them. Your heavenly Father feedeth them. Our heavenly Father takes care of them. Do they have doctors? He takes care of them. Do they have financiers? He takes care of them. Do they have benefactors? He takes care of them. Do they have people that can come to every night and every evening and to say, we have need of this, we have need of this? And Jesus said, your heavenly Father feedeth them. Are ye not much better than they? Much better than they? See how God is thinking about us. And see how God is thinking about you. And he says, I'm feeding all the animals. I'm feeding all the birds, all the fowls of the sky. And he says, you are much better than them. Verse 33, but seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. That's the better thing he says he's going to do. We're looking at Hebrews chapter 8, verse 6. Hebrews chapter 8. And we're looking at verse 6. Seeing what the Lord has promised, and seeing what he says he will give unto you. Hebrews chapter 8, we're looking at verse 6. But now, as he obtained a more excellent ministry, by how much also is the mediator of a better covenant, which was established upon better promises. That word better appears two times in a single verse. And it says, it's a better covenant. Look at the covenant he made with the children of Israel. That's what got them healed. What God has saved. That's why they said, bless the Lord, O my soul, who forgiveth all thine iniquities, who healeth all thy diseases. That was their covenant. And it says, beyond forgiving us all our iniquities, beyond healing us all our infirmities, it says, there's a better covenant that is based and established upon better promises. That's why the Lord is saying that this year is going to be better. Better for you, better for your family, and better for the church in every way. It will be confirmed and fulfilled in Jesus' name. Look at Hebrews chapter 11, verses 39 and 40. Hebrews 11, verses 39 and 40. And these all, having obtained a good report through faith, received not the promise. God, having provided some better thing for us. Think about that. As you think about this, chapter 11 of Hebrews is spoken about Abel, about Enoch, about Noah, about Abraham, about Sarah, about Isaac, about Jacob, about Moses, about all these people. And then he said, all these people are talking about, see what they got when they were sick, he healed them. When they were defeated, he gave them victory. He got them back again. And he said, they even subdued kingdoms and he stopped the mouths of lions. And the power of fire could not have any effect on them. And he said, even with all that they got, he said, God has now reserved and provided some better things for us, that without us, they should not be made perfect. As you see all those things I've read to you, that contains the word better, better, better every time. The Lord is telling us that this year is going to be better than last year. This year is going to be better than all the rest of your life that you ever live. Better things are coming this year in Jesus' name. I want to talk to you today on the blessed assurance of a better future. The blessed assurance of a better future. First of all, there's a better future. And then there's an assurance, and it's a blessed assurance. There's no shadow of doubt in my mind, and there's no doubt in your heart too, that according to the promise of God, which cannot fail, because God is not a man that he should lie, neither the son of man that he should repent. As he said, and shall he not do it? As he promised anything, and shall he not fulfill it? He has promised us a better future, and a better life, and a better victory, more than anything we got before, and is giving us this blessed assurance of a better future. I divide the message to three parts. Number one, the prophetic revelation of a better future. The prophetic revelation of a better future. Number two, our practical responsibility for a better future. If it's going to happen, I know it's going to happen. You have a part to play, I have a part to play, and we as a church together, we have a part to play. And it's as we play that part that the Lord will fulfill that better future for every one of us and for the future at large. Our practical responsibility for a better future. Number three, the progressive realization of a better future. The progressive realization of a better future. Number one, the prophetic revelation of a better future. We're coming back to Ezekiel, prophetic revelation. Revelation from God. What God says, this is my decision. This is my program. This is my project. This is the affirmation of what I'm going to do for you, of what I'm going to fulfill in your life. We're coming to Ezekiel chapter 34, and I'm reading there from verse 36. I'm sure you'd like to mark some of these things in your Bible, because during the year you need to be going back to it again, going back to it. The blessed assurance of a better future. The better future coming for me. The better future coming for you. And coming for every member of our families. In Ezekiel chapter 34. I'm reading from verse 26. And I will make them and the places round about my heel a blessing. Give me a good amen there. Yeah. And I will cause the shower to come down. Or in the season there shall be showers of blessing. Can I tell you this year? Change all those songs. You know, the width of people, they don't know. If you sing a bad song, it will give a bad idea, bad song. It will destroy your faith. You know, some people, it is not an easy road. Sometimes in the valley, sometimes on the mountain, it is not an easy road. Take that kind of song out of your mouth and begin to sing, there shall be showers of blessing, showers of blessing, showers of blessing. The dews are falling, but Lord, for the showers we plead, because this year is not going to be, you know, it is not an easy road. That song is not for this year. Maybe it's for the past. Now you've sung enough of that. Now the new song in your mouth, which is that there shall be showers of blessing. You wake up in the morning, there shall be showers of blessing. You're going on the road, there shall be showers of blessing. And then you know the better thing the Lord wants to do and the better future that he wants to give unto you, you sing it, you shout it, and then you pray it through, and then you possess it, and then I see it on your face, that brightness on your face. I say, this my brother has a better future, that my sister has a better future. It will be fulfilled in our lives in Jesus' name. Look at that. Again, I will make them and the places round about my heel a blessing, and I will cause the shower to come down in a season. There shall be showers of blessing. That's a prophetic revelation of the better future that the Lord has promised, and it is coming. I want you to look at chapter 35. I've read chapter 34. I'm going to chapter 35 now. In chapter 35, I'm reading from verse 3. It says, and say unto each, thus says the Lord God, thus says the Lord God, behold, O Mount Seir, I'm against thee, and I will stretch out my hand against thee, and I will make thee most desolate. I will lay thy cities waste, and thou shalt be desolate, and thou shalt know that I am the Lord, because thou hast had a perpetual hatred and has shed the blood of the children of Israel by the force of thy sword in the time of their calamity and in the time of their iniquity, that at an end, the Lord is saying, is going to rebuke your enemies. The enemies of the children of Israel, they were rejoicing over them. They were destroying them. And God said, now I'm waking up for my people. I'm waking up for my sons and my daughters and all those people that hated them. I'm going to deal with them. Look at what God is saying. And the Lord is saying then that the blessings of God is coming upon your life. And the enemies that kind of hindered you before and stopped you before and maneuvered everything before, they will not be able to do that this year, because this year you'll have victory over every spiritual enemy, human enemy, and circumstantial enemy in Jesus' name. Let's come to chapter 36. I read 34, 35, not 36. I'm reading chapter 36 from verse 9 now. It says, for behold, I am for you. The Almighty God, the one that the creator of the heavens and the earth, it says, I am for you. You know, never say again, I have nobody. Like Jesus Christ was asking that man, will thou be made whole? Will you be healed? Will you be prospered? Will you be happy? Will you be blessed? Will you receive a miracle? And he didn't know who Jesus was, that Jesus was for him. Jesus was in his side. Jesus that is greater than all his friends and all his enemies and all the people together. And when Jesus asked him, will you be made whole? He said, I have no man. When an angel comes and then he troubles the water to pick me up and throw me inside. And Jesus said, get up and take up thy bed and walk. And that's what the Lord is doing to you at this time. No more complaint. I have no man. I have no daddy, I have no mommy, I have no provider, I have no this, I have no helper. Now you have God, and God says in verse 9, I am for you, and I will turn unto you, and ye shall be tilled and sown. In verse 10, and I will multiply men upon you, and all the house of Israel, even all of it, and the city shall be inhabited, and the way shall be built, and the way shall be builded. Then what we read before, let's read that again, and I will multiply, verse 11, upon your man and beast, and they shall increase and bring fruit, and I will settle you after your old estate, and will do better unto you than at your beginnings, and ye shall know that I am the Lord. The Lord is assuring us that the blessings are coming. This year is going to be a better year, and this year is going to be the beginning of great breakthrough in your life. Things you have asked for before that you thought God had forgotten, that he has not answered, this year the answer is coming upon your life in Jesus' name. These are the prophetic revelations of a better future. What else are we looking for? And look at it from chapter 34 and 35 and 36. Look at chapter 37. Chapter 37, I'm reading from verse 26. Ezekiel chapter 37, verse 26, it says, moreover, I will make a covenant of peace with them, and it shall be an everlasting covenant with them, and I will place them and multiply them, and will set my sanctuary in the midst of them forevermore. Here the Lord is saying, a covenant of peace. All the unrest and all the trauma and all the depression and all the hassles of life, the Lord is saying, I'm taking everything away, because things are going to be different this year. All the things you have lost, all the things that are bringing that depression and that attack and that affliction in your life, the Lord is saying, enough is enough. It's going to take everything away and wipe everything away. What joy we have and what celebration we ought to have this year because of the great promise the Lord himself is giving us. Look at chapter 38. I'm reading from verse 23. Chapter 38, verse 23. Thus will I magnify myself and sanctify myself, and I will be known in the eyes of many nations, and they shall know that I am the Lord. The Lord said, I'm going to so set you apart that people will know that you belong to me. And my glory I will give unto you. And all the goodness that God has in the courts of heaven, he says, he'll shower it upon his people, that all the heathen and all the Gentiles round about, they will know that God is facing now the people of God, even to bless them. Let's look at chapter 39, verse 8. Chapter 39, verse 8. Behold, it is come, and it is done, says the Lord God. This is the day whereof I have spoken. You know what I'm showing you? I'm showing you from chapter to chapter, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, just going on like that. And the Lord, in one breath, from chapter to chapter, it just saying, blessings are coming, blessings are coming. He says, get your buckets ready, and get your containers ready, and get your enlarged heart ready, and say, Lord, pour them down. And the Lord is going to pour them down upon your life in Jesus' name. Look at chapter 40 now. Chapter 40, I'm reading from verse 4. It says, and the man says unto me, son of man, behold with thine eyes, and also hear with thine ears, and search thine heart upon all that I shall show thee, for to the intent that I might show them unto thee, had thou brought hither, declare all that thou seest to the house of Israel. It says, all the better things the Lord wants to do, all the good things the Lord wants to do, he has commanded us to declare it unto you. And everything is going to be done in Jesus' name. Have you seen something here? In seven